وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, today in this Friday sermon I just want to highlight one word in the Quran. So that word, which I feel it is the key of the Islamic, the concept of Islam, the key of monotheism and righteousness. That word is the word which is in the surah that I've just recited, that Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha, which almost every Muslim person memorizes this surah and knows it out of the heart, by heart. Everybody can recite and can read it. Even a child of 2 years old knows how to recite this surah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order not to make us the religion, to make the our religion and our activities very harsh and difficult, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala add the key word in this surah, so that nobody will have the excuse to say, I have never heard of this word. That's why Allah put it in this verse, this sentence in this surah, Surah Al-Fatiha. So the Surah Al-Fatiha also, you know, it is values. Everybody knows that it is very important, very significant, very valuable surah of the Quran, up to the level where some people may consider it that it is half of the Quran, or it is comparable with the Quran, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this surah these values and this preference. And Prophet Muhammad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran first, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. Indeed, we have given you سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي, seven of those seven values or seven important verses, which are in Surah Al-Fatiha, seven verses. وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. And we have given you also the great and the noble Qur'an. So you see, Allah compares here Surah Al-Fatiha with the Quran, the rest of the Quran. So then, there's this sentence, or this word, is in this Fatiha, which we recited minimum 17 times a day. Means each day we perform prayer, and Dhuhr is 5 rak'at. In each of these 5 rak'ats, we have to recite Fatiha, where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا صلاة لمن لم يقرأ بفاتحة الكتاب. There is no prayer for anyone who does not recite Surah Al-Fatiha in their prayer. So then we recite Fatiha minimum, at least in our prayers. It is more than 17 times then that everybody recites. But then there is one word in it, and if we understand and comply what this word is giving us or ordering us, we could have been successful. That word is, which is the, it is the bottom, it's the key word of the whole surah, and then the whole Quran. That is ihdina sirata al-mustaqim. So ihdina sirata al-mustaqim is this, is one sentence, but pick up one word from there, because you are saying ihdina, oh Allah, guide us, sirata al-mustaqim, guide us to the right path. The right path now is Allah is using mustaqim, mustaqim, the upright. This, the one which is steadfast, that is mustaqim. Now my point is to target that mustaqim. What is mustaqim only? Ihdina, only ihdina needs hundreds or more of lectures. Sirada, to explain the word sirada, needs tens and tens of lectures. Mustaqima, then needs tens of other lectures. So now my focus is on mustaqim. What is mustaqim? As we see in this verse, Allah says, "Ihdina sirata al-mustaqim." The whole Surah Al-Fatiha is a supplication, it's a prayer. So you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you guidance to the right path, and you maintain on it. You keep on being on that right path. Then that, Allah is telling, "Ahdina sirata al-mustaqim." So which is that sirat? Which street is that? Which path is it? Sirata al-ladina an'amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim, wal-dhalin. It is generally the right path, the one you have given. It is the one that followed by those you have given them the ni'mah. Those you have glorified them and an'amta alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Who are neither the ones who got a straight path, they went to the wrong direction, as then you became, your wrath fall upon them. وَلَضَّالِينَ, and not those who went to the wrong way out of ignorance. So that one needs a lot of discussion. I'm not going to explaining the which street is that, where is this path, and how it is. Even though, I would just like to touch one point, which is quite important, that many, many ulamas, even those who are, I'm talking about scholars, some of them, they say, sirada, this sirada is in the day of judgment, in the hereafter, the day of resurrection. But that is not the right definition of the sirada mustaqim. It is completely misleading of the Islamic concept, which makes the whole Islam is talking about the day of judgment and the day of the day of resurrection, what's happening that day. It's not information that's going to happen there. It is guidance. It is what you should be doing. So then Allah is telling us this sirat, which is in this world, our day-to-day activities. That's we are every single minute, we are on the sirat. So if we go wrong, then we are gone. We are on this highway, which is very clear. And if you know, if you are driving, you are on the highway and you pass the exit in a second, then it will take to you how long it will take you to come back and get that exit again, to get another exit, to go, to drive more and more. So you might drive 10 kilometers. So you lost even your appointment. You missed everything. Then this is how it is, the sirat. Is this sirat, we are on journey in this world. And we are on that sirat. The sirat is not the day of judgment then. And then when Allah is saying, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, I know many ulamas, even they just say, غير المغضوب, those Allah became mad at them and got the anger of Allah, they, They just say it's Jewish people, and all of Berlin are those the Christians. And that is not the right explanation. That is not correct. That is misleading. There's nothing, the Quran is not specify something. Maybe Quran takes, talks about one group or one tribe or one nation just as a case study, an example. But not that Quran specifies this one person and focus on that person or that community. So the meaning is that anybody who goes to the wrong way, then Allah, while he knows, or they all know that they are going to the right path, then Allah puts his anger on them. But those who go to the wrong way out of ignorance, then they are dhalim. So it is anybody, regardless of their tribe, regardless of who they are. And coming to my point, al-mustaqim. Mustaqim, to be always straight, to be on concentrating on something, focusing on that thing, and being always upright to it. So you must be someone who is conscious and always focusing on that thing. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. That on every second minute of our life, we must be focusing on Islam and being mustaqim, straightforward, directly. So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering us. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. Allah is saying, the good people are those who say, our Lord is Allah. And when they say that, it's not only verbal statement. It's not lip service. It's not that you just say I'm Muslim and my Lord is Allah. But ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا then they stand firm on it. So they are always, they are standing firm on that. They are steadfast and straight on this path. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. The angels descend upon them. And what they say to them, Allah takhafu wa la tahzanu. They say to them, don't be afraid and don't be worried about anything. So they say, Allah takhafu wa la tahzanu. Do not, there is no fear of what is going to come in the future. Fear always is what is facing to you, what is coming to you. So it relates to the future. And voila, it's what you, the present and the future, you are fearing of that. Wala tahzanu, and do not worry about your past, what the mistakes you have done in the past. So if you are worried about what has happened and your mind is not stable, then you are in a fear situation. You are not stable. But, and at the same time, when you are afraid, you fear of everything, then you are not stable also. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that those who say our Lord is Allah alone, and at the same time stand firm on it, then the angels will descend upon them and will tell them, don't worry and don't be afraid. You are fine. So then, وَأَبْشُرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ, and get glad tidings of the paradise that which was promised for you. The paradise that you had already, you got, it was promised for you to get it, is coming for you. So now you are safe, don't worry. That is only when you are get the istiqama, which is being always conscious and maintain, be always persistent of whatever you are doing, constant, So constantly you are praying, constantly you are helping others, constantly you are doing justice, constantly you are fair, constantly you are have mercy, you have sympathy, empathy to everybody, then you have good relationship with your Creator, and at the same time you have good relationship with the creatures. And that's the whole point of Islam, is that you must be someone who is standing firm, who is constant and persistent of doing good things. Not sometimes you do the worst and you expect that God is going to forgive you. So then our problem nowadays is that somebody is doing all kinds of wrong, mistakes, everything, committing crimes, all kinds of sins, but, and they say, don't worry, I'm gonna make dua, a special dua, sit down, give a charity or make a lunch or ceremony for somebody, and at the same time, I will get forgiveness. So the forgiveness is that you should remember, you cannot, who are you fooling? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who knows you, and who knows what is coming to your heart and your mind. So you cannot fool anybody. You should know that Allah already knows what is in your heart, what you are planning, what you are thinking about. All those things you must be keeping into your hand. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, the topic today is how we can get istiqama, or at least there, just to shed a light on the values of istiqama. And istiqama means being consistent all the time in doing good things, being the right person, not being somebody who is zigzag, who is doing today the best and tomorrow the worst, who is always and have double-faced, not the one who is always like intentionally doing shortcomings. If you are a human being, you may have been up and down, you may have some shortcomings, sometimes fall behind of some certain good things, but your main, you must be someone who is straightforward and standing firm on the right things. It's reported that one time a companion came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he asked him one question. He said, "Oh Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have one question." He said, "I have no time for learning this Quran, learning so and so, and a busy man, I have a lot of things to do." So that's how it means, it sounds, the way he spoke to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He didn't use these specific terms, but it seems like this. He said, "I need to ask you one question, which I will not ask anybody after you. If I get that the answer, then that's it, it's done. I want to go, because of that answer, I want to get to paradise." Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, "Qul amantu billah thumma istaqim." Say, "I believed in Allah, the Almighty, thumma istaqim." Then be standing firm on it. Don't change your mind. Don't just say, "I believed in Allah," and do again something which is opposite to what you have promised. So be straightforward. The sisters in the sisters, please, in the Friday sermon, if somebody speaks, that person will return with minus sin, not with reward. And also, if somebody, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if somebody says to the person who is next to them, says, please be quiet, just quiet. Then that person, his khutbah and his prayer is null and void. He wasted his time. What about the person who is talking? So inshallah, make sure you know that in the Friday sermons. And so Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him this answer. He said to him, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ. Say, I believed in Allah, and then keep on that. Don't change your way. Then, and so he said, if you do that, then you will inherit the Jannah. That will take you to Jannah, paradise. Only be straight on Islam, which is very easy. Even if you have never studied Islam, you know when you said, I believed in Allah, it means you should not worship anybody other than Allah or anything else, and you should only obey what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered you, the commandments Allah has given you, and stay away from the prohibitions, which are very common, that you should not bother human being or even animal and be right person. Just morality, it's common morality. At least if you don't have any other knowledge, then you know what is good and what is bad. You can differentiate between the good and bad. So then you can differentiate between the wrong and right, and then you are safe. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. And that's the purpose that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent. Allah sent tens and tens of messengers just because of that. To believe in one Allah and then to follow His commandments and to stay away from the prohibitions, which are commandments, just to have that. And that's why some ulama, they take the word sabr, which is patience, they also make it in line with the word of istaqama, which says they are interchangeable in this case. Because when you have patience, you will be patient of doing the good things, even if you don't like them. And also, you take patience from doing the wrong things. There are many things that you love so much. Maybe you think it will give you some benefits of economic benefit or social benefit or so and so. But you, if that's all your own imagination, it is ostensible issue. It's not reality. It's fake in your mind. But you love it because there's Satan which is already influencing you. So then that is how sabr and istiqama are comparable. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in most of the prophets, for example, in the case of Hud and Yunus, Allah says, Allah says, قَدْ أَجَابَتْ دَعْوَتُكُمَا فَاسْتَقِيمَا وَلَا تَتَّبِعَانِ. Allah has answered your prayer. So, فَاسْتَقِيمَا, be straight and stand firm on it. Be steadfast on that. So that Allah is saying to the prophets, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُ. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعِ الْهَوَى. So be straightforward and stand firm on what I have ordered you, and do not follow the small leaves and loopholes, being straight. And Allah says in another verse, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُ وَمَنْ تَبَعَكَ مِنْهُمْ. So it means straight you and anyone who follows you, be standing firm on the right path. Don't make any chance or any other kinds of inclination. So istiqama is this way. This istiqama, the whole point is that every single day, when we are praying, when we are reciting Fatiha, when we are making dua, we say, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path. But at the same time we do wrong things, then that means you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, and it is you who is doing always the opposite. That is where it comes, مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلُهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. That is where some people say it comes that you are the one who is taking yourself to the wrong way. But Allah never takes somebody to the wrong way. Allah created all human beings with fitrah, in good condition, in good situation, innate capacity, that's what you have. But it's you who changes it. So what if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you to the right path, but you are always running after the wrong path, means this is devil agent. You are, that is hypocrisy. That you are trying to fool Allah. You are trying to be this person who is, has multiple colors and multiple minds. So be one person who is straightforward on Islam. And but if you become devil, if you have devil minds and doing devil actions which are opposite to each other, that is the signs of hypocrisy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even in the first that I have just recited, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, at the end Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُنَافِقِينَ, and tell the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, that they will have a torment hellfire. And Allah says, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ, indeed the hypocrites will be is dwelling in at the bottom of the hellfire. That is where the cooking is. The hellfire is cooked from the bottom, and they will be staying there. عباد الله يوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل وحذركم بنفسه ونفسكم بمخالفة الله والثانية.